Welcome to the strength of materials class, simple stress and strain. We have seen the numerical related to elongation of the bar in the previous video. In this, the same part, numerical on elongation of a bar. Now in this video, I'll be discussing with the particular numerical which was conducted as the test of the tensile test on the mild steel bar. A tensile test was conducted on a mild steel bar. The following data was obtained from the test. So now we know how was the tensile test is conducted. A specimen is of this way, wherein the specimen is having a tapering end and it is having a gripping end. So this way the specimens is used. Tension is pulled on this direction, tension is pulled on this direction. We need to remember how is the particular section we have to consider. So in this, the diameter of the steel bar is given. This is the particular diameter of the steel bar. Let us take the diameter as 3 cm of the bar. Then they say the second mark is gauge length of the bar. So we are marking this as the gauge length, not the total length. I repeat, the gauge which we mark, it is the gauge length of the particular bar. For the tensile test which was conducted, it is 20 cm and diameter is of 3 cm. Now remaining part is what is the total load at elastic limit. When it was pulled, what was the load at elastic limit? Extension at the load of 150 kN is equals to 0.21 mm. So when it was 150 kN, the extension took place was 0.21 mm. Maximum load, how much it has taken? It has taken 380 kN maximum load. So total extension, how much was there? So the total extension was about 60 mm. Then what was the diameter when a rod was going to fail? So how to understand this part? If we see this was a pulling, we can say that the central part of the diameter which was 3 mm, it will get reduced due to the pull in the bar to the smaller diameter. Now this was of 3 cm, but whereas this particular diameter will be of, as mentioned in the question, it is of 2.25 cm. So now need to understand why it is going to happen. So when we try to pull a particular rod, it is able to stretch. Now when we are able to stretch it, it will get compressed or it will get elongated. When it is getting elongated, this particular lateral dimension will be coming, reducing its area, will be trying to get compressed. Means when we try to pull something, the lateral dimension means the width or the breadth of the particular member or the specimen will get reduced. So this way the particular bar is also getting reduced. For this reason we are able to get that particular diameter as 2.25 cm. Now when we are able to pull, so for if I try to plot the particular graph of the tensile test this way, we have to remember this also because this is the most part of importance, sigma, and here we plot it as the strain. So when we try to apply, this is going to have the linear movement and some part of yielding is going to happen, then it will be again going further and further the maximum ultimate load, and then we are going to have the failure points. So this is the tension test which is conducted on the mild steel. Now how the diameter was there at this particular zero point? At this zero point we can see, so at this zero point we were having diameter as 3 cm, and length of gauge was of 20 centimeter. When the extension, so elastic load limit is how much? 250 kilonewtons. So when it was here, so elastic load limit, so this is particular elastic region, we can say this is the elastic region. If we unload from 250, it will try to come back at some particular point. It may not be the same 3 centimeter and 20 centimeter, some part is going to get loading. So this is 250 kilonewton. Now again it is saying some value for us, that is 150 kilonewton is equals to 0.21 mm of extension. So somewhere here that time, this level, it was 150 mm, agreed. So it was 150 mm means we can say what was the extension occurred, what was the pull. Extension means this 20 centimeter plus 0.2 mm. It has gone further. It has gone further. This 20 centimeter plus 0.2 mm, it has gone further. Means its length is increased in this particular gauge part. In this particular gauge part, the length is increased. Because of the length is increased in the gauge part, we can say that the gauge length is in this part, it is increasing. Now when we go for this 250 kilonewton, clear? So after the whole part is completed, the test is completed up to the failure part, the total extension was 60 mm. The total extension was 60 mm. And also we need to understand maximum load was how much. So maximum load, it was here, the ultimate maximum load. So at this point, the maximum load was taken as 380 kilonewtons. So this is the main question which we have to first of all understand for this. And when the particular failure occurred, this point the failure occurred, we can say at this point the failure is going to occur. At this point when the failure occurred, the diameter of the rod was is equals to 2.25 centimeters. We have to keep it in mind. These are the details which are given by the question. Now we need to go for determining the Young's modulus, stress at the elastic limit, percentage elongation and percentage decrease in area. So what is stress of what is the Young's modulus? Stress upon strain. Then what is stress? Load upon area within the elastic limit. Within the elastic limit we have to find, okay. Then the percentage elongation, how much is the percentage elongation we have to find. Then the percentage decrease in area, how much is the percentage decrease in area. So let us go for the solution of this particular problem. So what all data is known to us and how we are going to take this data for the particular formation part. So area of rod A, we have to find out, that is the area formula, pi by 4 into d square. When we substitute 3 centimeter, so it is in 3 centimeter square, we will be getting 7.0685 centimeter square. So if I multiply by 10 raised to minus 4 into this, it will be coming in meter square. So we have to remember this, centimeter square to meter square I am going. So this is centimeter square to meter square we are going to convert. I am going with 10 raised to minus 4. So divide by 10,000 it is. Divided it by 10,000, which will give you that 10 raised to minus 4. When I divide, 7.0685 by the 10,000 value, I'll be able to see that we are able to get it in meter square. Then coming to stress. Now stress, load upon area. What was the load in the elastic limit? It was 150 kilonewton. So 150 is kilonewton, multiplied by 1000 will give us in newton. So K kilonewton to newton when we require. So this is 1, so it will be equal to 1000 newtons. So this is 1000 newtons of value is 1 kilonewton. Divided by what is the area? Now this is the particular area, 7.0685 into 10 raised to minus 4. So we will be able to find out what is the stress in terms of newton per meter square. No need to change further or later. You can also keep this meter square in terms of centimeter square, but if you change it to meter square, a unique values, then we will be having a correct values. Now coming to strain, increase in the length or extension value divided by original length or gauge length. We need to understand this. There are two types of formulas which can be prepared. One is increase in length upon original length or extension divided by gauge length. So what is the extension? It is 0.2 mm. And what is the gauge length? Gauge length is 20 centimeters. 20 centimeters. I need to convert this 20 centimeters into mm. I'll multiply with 10. So 1 centimeter is equals to 10 mm. So which will be becoming as 200 mm. So 0.21 divided by 200 mm, I'll able to get this particular value as the strain. This is dimensionless. This is dimensionless. Please remember that strain is not having any dimension. It is a dimensionless. Otherwise, if you write mm, it is totally wrong. So please don't write any value for the strain values. So this is stress, this is strain. Now coming to Young's modulus. Young's modulus is what? E is equals to stress upon strain. So this value of stress and this value of strain, when we are able to know, just substitute into stress upon strain formula for Young's modulus, we are able to find out the Young's modulus as 2020952 3 into 10 raised to 4 newton per meter square. So converting this into the giga newton per meter square, which is 10 raised to 9. If we keep this 10 raised to 9 as a showing, we have to write the value in terms of newton per meter square. If we are going to hide this 10 raised to 9, then this 10 raised to 9 will turn in terms of giga value, that is G. Second part. The stress at the elastic limit is given by stress is equals to load at elastic limit divided by area. What was the load at elastic limit? It was 250 kilonewtons into 10 raised to 3, converted it into newtons. So now it is 25000 and 1 more 0. So it is totally 250,000. Divided by what is the area? Area in calculated meter square. So we are able to get the stress. So this was the stress. This is 10 raised to 4. Please have a mild part of correction. This is 10 raised to 6. It is raised to, not at 104. Please have this correction. 10 raised to 4 and 10 raised to 6. I'll write once again. It is 10 raised to 4 and this is 10 raised to 6 newton per mm square. So when this value is there, this is the 10 raised to 4 newton per mm square. When this value, we are going to take 353.68 into 10 raised to 6 newton per meter square, and finally it is converted as mega newton per meter square. The third part, percentage elongation is obtained as, what is the percentage elongation? How much was the elongation occurred? So percentage elongation, total increase in length upon original length multiplied by 100 will come. This formula already we have used. Where we have used? We have used it for the strain part. Strain, increase in length or extension divided by original length. So the same formula for percentage elongation, also taking increase in length divided by original length. But here the total increase in length is most important point. Total increase in length divided by original length multiplied by 100, when we do, we are able to have the percentage elongation as 30%. This is 20 into 10 mm means 200. This is 20 centimeters, which I am converting it into mm. Finally, the percentage decrease in area is obtained as percentage decrease in area is equals to original area minus area at failure. What is the original area? Then area at the failure. So, divided by original area into 100. So, small correction, this is not a 2. I'll make this part more clear for you. This is square of that. So, when we take 3 square, 2.25 square, again 3 square, this is 3 square, this is 2.25 square, this is 3 square. So, original area is what? Pi by 4 into d square. And this minus area at the failure, it is pi by 4 into 2.25 square divided by original area, again pi by 4 into d by d square, that is 3 square, then whole multiplied by 100. So we can say that pi by 4 minus pi by 4 divided by pi by 4, it gets cancelled. Pi by 4 gets cancelled, pi by 4 gets cancelled. Need not worry about the pi by 4. Now 3 square minus 2.252 square, when we do, this part of value is going to come divided by 3 square again, then multiplied by 100. If we do, we are able to have this as 43.75. so this step, I'll show you what I have written. It is 3 square minus 2.25 square divided by 3 square multiplied by 100. It is before this how it was written. It was written like this: pi by 4 into 3 square minus pi by 4 into 2.25 square bracket divided by pi by 4 into 3 square multiplied by 100. So this is the step which is written here, and this part of step is written at this level. So the final answer what we are able to get is 43.75%. So this is the final answer of fourth part. This numerical to try as an assignment, I'll just explain this numerical for your clarification. Same tensile test was conducted on a mild steel bar. Diameter of a steel bar is 4.5 centimeter. Gauge length of a bar is 25 centimeter. Load at elastic limit is 275 kilonewton. Extension at a load of 100 kilonewton is 0.25. Maximum load is 400 kilonewtons. Total extension taken place is 75 mm. Diameter of the rod at the failure is 2 centimeter. Everything remains same, only with the same formulas you have to calculate, values are going to change. So please try this as an assignment. You have to submit it when will be asked. Thank you. See you in the next video.